Yeah, so tell us your name and which parish you're from.
Well, I'm Clarence Renault, and I'm from St. Andrews, Grenada, East, the Eastern Parish in Grenada. And as you know, Grenada is located in the Caribbean, or what was known long time back in the day as the West Indies.
The West Indies. How did we get that name? Because a lot of people is confused when they hear the word West Indies. What is the history behind that name?
That's why I use the word Caribbean first, the name Caribbean first, because the name West Indies came about through what was called the discovery of the islands in the Caribbean by people like Christopher Columbus and other explorers from Europe. And it's because it came about because of the people that were the indigenous people that were met here, they were Red Indians. So, and Columbus sailed westward from Europe in order to get to here. So west, in other words, they call them West Indians from the west. Okay? Indigenous people were considered to be Indians, but living in the West,
In the West, right.
as
And
opposed to,
who were the indigenous people that Columbus met here
well,
before the Africans came in?
they were called Caribs and Arawaks, but the modern name, I think, is especially Caribs are now called Kalinago people, and there are islands in the West Indies here, or Caribbean, that still have descendants. Islands like Dominica and Saint Vincent, I think. Stand to be corrected, but you know, they
So
still have descendants,
it's
and
a small percentage of them. Which African country that you think you are a descendant from?
oh boy, that's a difficult one because Africa is such a diverse, complex nation, country, I should say, that I've not done any sort of research or tracing back of my heritage, from my African heritage, and I don't know why, but it just doesn't, it seems as though it doesn't matter to me now, because growing up, going to school, I should say, I was really disturbed, greatly disturbed by the thought of the, when I got to learn of
Okay, what happened?
the
The
slavery.
slaves and all what they went through.
But yet the system had me in a way whereby I sort of, when I was a very young age, teenager stage perhaps, I was like ashamed to be called black. Have you noticed, I do not have the this dark complexion as most pure African people, because of, and that's because of the legacy of colonialism. And so, because I consider myself, when I look back at the that's a few, maybe.
So do you consider yourself an African? Do
What?
you, because I heard you said you were ashamed.
Yes,
So
well,
where do you stand now, knowing that you are much older in age? There's a saying, the older you get, the wiser you get. You get to learn certain things. Are you proud of your, how to say, African identity? Because, it doesn't matter how much we try to ignore the fact that this happened. It actually happened. That is just what it is.
No.
So my question is, are you proud to be an African descendant?
Yes, I am, to put it short. But I would like to elaborate on that because this is a very interesting topic. I'm subject. The fact that we have been colonized and indoctrinated in such a way that we sort of accept Western teachings as the ideal.
Right, right.
Okay, but in growing up again, I learned a lot about African history and culture through music, for example, reggae music, because that was one of my favorite genres in music, reggae music. So people like Bob Marley and Peter Tosh, and what's his name? One that went back to live to Africa. Anyhow, you know, these Jamaican artists, singers, spread a lot of truth about colonialism, slavery, and African things.
Yeah.
People like Marcus Garvey and Malcolm X, and that's in America, and other black leaders who preach things like repatriation and made slogans such as Africa for Africans at home and abroad. These things resonated with me heavily during my young adult life. And so I feel proud knowing that Africa is called the mother of civilization.
Right.
The cradle of civilization. You know, and there are some who hold the view that Africa is where life started, actually started.
Started,
Rastafarians, for example, believe that Ethiopia is where places like Mount Zion is. And the Garden of Eden. And places like that. Rastafarians thought that, well, they taught other people. They used to say, in other words, that Africa is the location where the Bible was, most of the historical names and places in the Bible is speaking of Africa.
Okay.
Now, as I said, I've not done much research into the history and culture, but naturally, I personally, and I've studied back the from my generations in my family. Back then. What I've discovered is that I'm mixed maybe about three or four ways.
Okay.
Okay?
You're mixed?
Yes.
Okay.
Primarily black.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
That's African.
African.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then there's a big slice of Indian heritage in me.
Okay, right.
As well as European.
Okay.
If you notice, the name Renault is a French name.
Right.
Yeah?
Right.
My first name is English. In fact, my first and middle names are English. I have a French surname. And that came from the French colonizers, because, you know, Grenada was colonized by both French
and British. Britain. Yeah.
You know, and the Renault is from the side where Fedo.
Okay.
Yeah, my perhaps great grandfather was a fighter alongside Fredo in the rebellion back in 1700s.
Right.
Yeah.
So as you said, it's a bit complex to.
Yes.
But what with just a you know, I guess, you know, what, where do you think? I mean, in your opinion, even though it's a complex issue, in your opinion, where you think, you know, you might possibly trace back your ancestry when it comes to the motherland.
Talking about specific country.
Specific, yeah, countries. Well, you know, our viewers by now knows that Grenadians don't really see Africa like Ghana, Nigeria, all these places as countries. We just refer to Africa as Africa.
As one country.
As one country. That's that. They already know that. But, you know, for all of you as there to get a proper understanding, you know, which part, which state of Africa do you think you derive from?
Oh, I love dancing. I love.
No, but which part? Yeah.
Just.
Yeah.
And there was some point in time when I think I read something somewhere
mm-hmm.
that said you can discover the place you come from in Africa from the way you move to the beats, musical beats.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But I've never gone so far as to think, but it has to be somewhere in West Africa.
West Africa, yeah.
Somewhere around,
and you mentioned dancing. So
yes.
Dancing has is when it comes to West Africa, Ghanaians like to dance.
Okay,
you have Nigerians they like to dance. So yeah. It probably might be these two countries.
Could be,
and not excluding the other countries because
Mali
and you know Senegal and Sierra Leone. Yes. You know, yeah. So all right, that's interesting.
But the type of dance, you know?
Yeah, yeah. That's interesting.
The type of dance could be traced back to
one of these countries. Okay.
For example, the Karikunyas, Grenada, mm-hmm. that's our sister isle.
Yeah.
Out there.
Yeah.
Have this big drum dance that they do.
Yeah.
And I think it can be traced back to Senegal.
Okay.
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 And this the what they call it? There's a festival in Kariku every year.
Mm-hmm.
Sometime every year that where they do the big jump dance and not the regatta.
Mm-hmm. Maroon. Right, the Maroon Festival. My brother, tell me your name and which parish you're from in Grenada.
Alright, my name is Kaunda Thomas and I'm from Moya St. Andrews.
Alright, Kaunda Thomas. Yeah, Kaunda is an African name.
Yeah, man. Straight out Africa.
Which African country you think you are descendant from?
Well, I think I'm descendant from Ghana.
Ghana?
Yes.
Okay, Ghana, West Africa.
West Africa.
Ghana. Right. Have you heard your parents talk before about your ancestors coming from Ghana, or you just know within you?
Well, within me, I just find it's within me because I never heard my parents and things talk about it, but within me, I find I come from West Africa in Ghana.
In Ghana,
yes,
right.
My ancestors come from West Africa.
You're confident,
confident
that this
fully,
is Ghana? It's Ghana.
Ghana.
Good. Yeah. So, my brother, what do you think and know about Africans at large?
Well, between me and you, I think and I know that Africans are like our kind, our blood, and most importantly, like our family.
Our family. So, yeah. As a Grenadian, or can you say Grenadians, we don't see Africa different from us?
No.
We see them as our own brothers and sisters.
Own brothers and sisters.
Good.
Why do you love Africa and Africans?
Well, to my understanding, I love Africa, number one, the food.
Okay.
Number two, the movies. Number three, most importantly, number three, the dance.
The dance.
The Afrobeat.
Right, right.
I love
right.
this in Africa.
So, Afrobeat, what about the Afrobeat you like about? What is it
well,
about it?
To me, as a dancer, mm-hmm. and about the Afrobeat, just the rhythm in it alone makes you feel to dance. And if you just think about Africa alone,
mm-hmm.
you know it's dancing and real vibes.
Yeah, yeah.
So, I love Afrobeat to the fullest.
Right, right. And I hear you talk about the food. What about the food? Have you ever tasted African food
well,
or?
On the other hand, as I say, I love dancing, and but in real life, I'm a chef.
Oh,
so,
okay.
I try different style. I try different African food and I taste different
so
African
my
Afri- food.
So my African brothers, we have a chef right here, a Grenadian
yeah,
chef.
Man.
Yeah. Have you tried African cook African food before?
Well, I cook African food before, you know. Fufu.
Right, fufu, right?
Yeah, I tried fufu and it went well.
Right,
it
right.
was delicious. Other people love it.
Yeah,
the only
yeah.
thing was I didn't get to serve it to a real African.
Okay, okay.
But it was delicious.
So who did you get to serve it to?
Well, I serve it to people from England, people from Grenada. So,
right, right.
People from different Caribbean.
Right, okay,
yeah.
right. Oh, so what fufu consists of? How do you prepare fufu? Is this something we
wow.
can do here in Grenada?
Well, I don't know. You could do it in Grenada if you want.
Okay.
But I don't know if African people is, you know, I'm going to say we're different food from different places.
Yeah.
Just be. But you could try it at home.
Yeah.
Try it at home and, you know, if you don't know, I could
right,
give you a link.
Right, yeah, man. Yeah. And the culture, I think you talk about the culture. What about the culture you like? About what African culture?
Yeah, I love.
Can you say that most of the cultures like we see, especially from Nigeria and Ghana, is similar to our culture here in Grenada?
Well, yeah,
mm-hmm.
similar because we have like things like the Shango and stuff like that.
Right, the Shango.
It's
right.
similar to the way how African do the carnival.
Okay.
So, I don't know if it's carnival, but the way how they dance.
They dance, yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. yeah.
Similar to that, so.
Right, and what the Shango is? What the Shango consists of?
Well, the Shango
are they drums?
Drums.
Uh huh.
That nerve dancing,
right?
Candlelighting.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
It's like a more spiritual thing.
Things,
so,
right, right.
Yeah, I don't really understand the full, but it's a spiritual thing.
Yeah.
And it's something that entertains you, so you feel good at the end of the day.
Okay. Yeah.
yeah. yeah.
Which is your favorite African country?
Well, the number one, Nigeria.
The giants of Africa?
Yes, that is just my favorite.
Right. What about Nigeria you like?
Well, I like the movie stars.
The movie, all right.
Keke
right.
and Popo. Big up to all yourself. I love Keke and Popo. That's my number one.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, one.
Yeah.
Like my cousin. Yeah, yeah that's my blood.
Right, right, right.
Yeah.
And that's the two short boys, the,
yeah,
the small fellas.
Two, yeah.
Right, right.
Keke and Popo.
Keke and Popo. Right.
Oh,
and Pish.
And Popo, so, yeah, some, yeah.
Okay, and Pishans and all of
and,
them.
I don't know enough of them name, but I also remember Rajan.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it seems as though you grew up watching a lot of Nigerian movies.
Exactly, especially my mom. Wow.
Yeah, okay. And it's true that movies... Or through the Nigerian movies, you get to understand more about your brothers and sisters in Africa.
Exactly.
Right, right. All right. What message do you have for Africans who do not value Africa?
Well, to my saying, to those who don't value Africa, please cherish your country.
Yeah.
There are some of us outside here who are willing and dying to come in our country.
Yeah.
Trust me, our country is like gold.
Real talk.
Yeah, your country is like gold. So cherish your country.
Yeah, yeah.
You got people like me, Kaunda Thomas, willing to come to Africa anytime, any day.
Yeah.
So cherish your country.
What message do you have for Grenadians or Caribbeans who do not want to associate with Africa?
Well, the message I have for Grenadians or the Caribbean who don't want to associate themselves with Africa is that if you know the true definition of love,
Yeah.
African people is just like we know love.
Yeah.
So the best way to associate to them is true love.
Yeah.
So that's the
message. And what message you have for people who are ashamed to be Africans or be ashamed of the identity of African?
Well, the message for to be ashamed of Africans, well, it's time to stop, because at the end of the day, we all are Africans,
yeah,
and we need to be there for each other.
Right, right, right. So there you have it, my brothers and sisters. Another Grenadian perspective of what we think of Africa. This is Kawunda. Peace out.